Hi everybody, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to see how to run Punishing Gray Raven on PC. As you can see now, you are watching it on screen. It will be possible to effortlessly download and install Punishing Gray Raven and enjoy playing this game on our Windows computer using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's go buddies. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue. Going to this URL I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type the URL, simply because I added a clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We ended up there on our own website of Usitility, where we get a precise description on the best way to download Punishing Gray Raven on laptop or computer. We search lower a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will run to enjoy the game Punishing Gray Raven on the PC. It is now obvious that we get a number of pros of running the emulator. So we are ready to start downloading the Punishing Gray Raven by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on the button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to run the installer. Okay, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to find the installer better. The installation software is really straightforward. It contains two options, install, and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path does. We basically just click on it. And therefore we note that they got here the path in which the emulator will be set up. If we prefer to change this folder, we must click on that browse option, and we pick another directory and install the emulator where we like. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I just click install. Fantastic. The setup commences and it's going to continue together with the download of those megabytes that happens to be displayed on our computer screen. When you download it, it could be a little bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate will go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your connection and according to the speed capacity of the emulator servers. At the moment they are going quite fast. The download is completed, then at present it continues with the installation step. The setup will take a little bit more or less time depending on the strength of your computer or laptop. The more powerful it actually is, the shorter the installation time and vice versa. If we add together the download and software installation phase, it will take a very long time, so have patience. It is by now finished on my side. At present, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right, so when it gets into the end, the emulator is launched for the first time. Indeed, the emulator has been started, here for the first time. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it has made two icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the one we're focused on. Whenever we desire to operate Punishing Gray Raven on our PC, we twice click this software icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything at all like this. In fact, it's an icon that we would very likely never work with. Shall we conduct the next phase? That is a must, and that's to log on to the Google Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is started. At this point we must sign in. So now once we're there, we must begin doing this next step that is definitely mandatory. Therefore just click on, sign in. Presently it shows, checking info. It could in some cases get stuck in, checking info, and this isn't going to move forward. In this case, you may attempt to log in after a few hours, but it will surely quite likely be fixed. At this time we're going to provide our email and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. As an example, you could use the same email address you are using right now in your YouTube account. Then I will enter my info and I'll return after I have completed it. Voila, info typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us the twos. We are going to say yes to them by just pressing, I agree. Following that, it makes us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked, it's going to create a backup of the data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started without need to open it manually and immediately. To install the app game, We have got to go to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on the app icon marked green colored. At present that we are discovering the desktop of that Android emulator, we see that we now have right here the install game option. We click on this button. Listed here we have got the game app. Let's quickly click on there on the install link that I'm presenting now in green. That click will commence the software installation. At present it will install the game. It typically takes a while, or perhaps it may just be very fast. That all relies upon on our internet connection. This has just finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking this specific button that I am presenting in green, so that you can launch Punishing Gray Raven for the very first time. Now let's simply click on this My Games option above. You are now on the emulator desktop, then we're going to just click on that new Punishing Gray Raven software icon that has been provided. Your game app is started for the first time on your device. There we get it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the sound level of this emulator. It is here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. This one is actually the very first one. We mouse click on this software icon which I am actually designating in green. Thus the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Granted that we would like to run the video game in full screen, we hit this particular icon. And we'd presently be experiencing the game in full screen setting. To exit the complete screen mode, hit the F11 key. And additionally we would certainly currently end up being in normal computer screen setting. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping, which is actually quite interesting. That way we will probably be in a position to use the game app much more easily. The first task is to mouse click this keyboard icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to complete the required configurations. I'm going to put the default settings, but if you require to adjust it, you can easily achieve it without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Occasionally it happens that the emulator is started in the wrong language, such as, in Chinese. And as a consequence to place it in the proper language we go here to the cogwheel. And thus there throughout additional settings, we just click on the language drop down. We can easily choose the language we need, English, Mandarin, and so on. Once the language is decided, we should save, the emulator would restart, as well as the Android game. The next time we start it, will as well be in the specified language. So now, you can find another thing that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will get a message from Gmail telling you that a new electronic device has been associated with our Google account. It will certainly ask us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yes, we ought not get worried, as the emulator is acting as an Google Android electronic device. So you can find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated. We arrive here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Let's browse here to the model selection. And right here we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our training. I hope you enjoyed it, specifically that you thought it was useful. If that's so, allow it a good thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, requests or ideas. Leave them in the comment field down below. You could also leave comments on my Twitch channel. I conduct live streams every once in a while. You get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of those training videos that are appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch, and let's have fun again in the next video tutorials. Bye.